Oh, okay. Monthly jail reports. We've got the monthly jail reports again, and we have improved business to the point that we have 91 people as of the first of the month in jail. We still have our same problem. We have 10 people in jail who have been in there. The oldest one, I think, is the seventh month of 2010, and I cut it off at the eighth month of 2012, which was 6 months ago. So we've got 10 people who have been in jail for anywhere from 6 months to almost 2.5 years, with the district attorney sitting over there and taking his sweet time deciding what he's going to do and when he's going to do it. And I know people talk about, well, you know, he's made a deal and he's covering this and he's covering that. I'm not sure that that's what we are paying him to do. We're paying him to try cases, put people in jail, and get it over with. These people, these 10 people in particular, deserve a whole lot better treatment than Beaufort County, the district attorney, and the court system is giving them. Because the Constitution of the United States says you're entitled to a speedy trial. And I realize that through the system and people making money out of it and all of that, that that has become warped with time. But with our particular jail situation that we have right now, if we did not have these 10 people in prison and they had been moved on to either back out on the street or into the state prison, we would only have 81 people in jail. And that you're getting down, you're getting your numbers down. And this is what jail management is called. We literally have no jail management on the part of the district attorney and the county and a whole lot of other things, and that's why everybody's clamoring to build a bigger jail so we can continue to house our mismanagement of prisoners. That's what it's all about, and I will be giving this report again next month. Some of these people are in here for murder, some of them are in here for rape, some of them are in here for drug possession, et cetera, et cetera. There's no reason that they can't be tried. These cases can't be tried, and they can't be moved on. And to that end, Mr. Stand-In Manager, do you have a report on the request that we again made to the district attorney to make an appearance before us and explain why things are moving so slowly?
No, sir, and it's only because I hadn't been involved in that discussion. I know Mr. Woodruff had pursued that, so I don't have anything to report, and I hadn't spoken with Mr. Woodruff concerning that.
Well, I would like the board by consensus or by vote, whichever way that we need to do it, to again request that the district attorney make an appearance before the Board of County Commissioners and help us understand why we have all these people in jail.
Fair question. So moved.
Second. Okay, that was a motion then.
Okay. We have a motion and a second. Now discussion.
Mr. Richardson, I understand that some of the reason why these prisoners are in jail for such a long period of time is they're having trouble getting DNA evidence.
No, sir, that's not true. I've already torpedoed the DA on that. He's tried that over and over and over. And if I may take some of your time to explain that, I'll do it again. I've talked to LabCorp, one of the largest corporations in the world. They do DNA testing. They would be delighted to enter either to come on an individual case and do the DNA work, which takes 6 weeks, or they would be delighted to enter into a longer-term contract to do all of our stuff, provide the expert testimony that's necessary. I've spoken to Mr. Byrd, who runs the North Carolina, I don't know what, it's crime, whatever it is the state does, it's runs SBI. Their laboratory, SBI laboratory. And Mr. Byrd says to me, quote, "A lot of people like to use us for an excuse for their inability to get their job done." And he says that when it's necessary, they can move cases out and get work done as fast as anybody can, that anybody that's using laboratory bottlenecks as an excuse is not being straightforward.
Okay. I have a motion and a second. All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed. 4-3.
Okay. Would you please ask?
Could I go back and ask a question about the?
Well, if the chairman.
We've got to finish this first.
We haven't finished this.
No. Then.
Which?
About the daily jail population. I was just wondering, with it being 99, if we have any prisoners housed off site, shouldn't we know that too?
There are not any, to my knowledge. Are there?
I am.
How many are housed off site?
Well, just hold, we'll come back to that. Let's finish what we got before us.
Okay, well, we're doing the jail report. I mean.
No, you're doing the DA thing right now. That's what I'm saying. You had something you wanted to add about that. I said, let's finish that.
Oh, okay. Well, what you're saying is jump down the list and do the DA thing.
No, that's what you were doing.
Yeah.
You just voted on that, and then you said you had something else for that. And I was saying, finish what you were going to say.
I'm lost.
Okay.
I'm going back to, I'm operating off of this schedule here.
But if you had one of these little pads.
No, I've got it right here in writing, which says monthly jail reports. So I was doing jail reports, and Jerry's right. We did jump down the list and got off on the DA. And as far as I'm concerned, I've got to vote on the DA. I mean, it's over with.
Okay.
Although if other commissioners have questions they need cleared up, like Gary brought up a good point, is that, you know, they're using DA as the excuse, and it's not an excuse. It's not a legitimate excuse at all.
Okay, well, go ahead then.
Okay. Trying to follow this schedule.
Yeah, the question I asked was in relation to how many prisoners we might be housing off-site right now.
Okay.
And she was going to answer that.
Come to the podium.
Good afternoon. At this present time, we have four.
They're housed off-site?
That's correct.
Why are they housed off-site?
Because you can't house them in the facility.
Why?
Because due to medical reasons.
Are all four of them medical reasons?
No.
No, we're not looking for something general now. We got four people. We need to discuss these specifically, these four people, without generalities. How many of them are medically there because medically they can't stay in this jail?
One.
Okay. How many are there for other reasons?
Three.
Okay. What are those reasons?
We have issues with housing. I mean, you got to be able to segregate those people. When those people come in and they're on the same case.
Well, what classification of criminal would they be that they can't be down there?
They're felonies.
They're felons.
They're felons, but they're on the same case. Sometimes when they come in, co-defendants, you can't house them. Yeah, you can't house them together.
Right. I understand.
We were having housing issues. People were fighting and things of that nature. And after a person gets in two, three, four fights, you know, you need to house them somewhere else. If not, you just.
So we have 91 plus four the first of the month. There's 95 prisoners in the custody of Beaufort County.
That's correct.
Okay. All right. And how long have they've been incarcerated? Are they on this report to know how long they've been incarcerated?
The when people that are housed off-site?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
They're on this report?
Yes, they are.
Okay. All right. Well, I had those numbers don't quite fit. So what I would suggest that we do to make sure the numbers fit on the future reports, when you give us this report each month, you give us the number that are housed off-site.
The number that's housed off-site is on, you're looking at your district attorney's list. Those are the people that are scheduled for trial. If you look at your jail inmate population list.
That's this?
Yes, sir.
All right. See, this doesn't give me, okay, how do I know they're housed off-site?
Because it's going to say safekeeping.
All right. That was a question I had. Okay, good.
Excuse me, you said safekeeping?
Yes. Yes, sir.
All right. All right, great. Okay, so we've got what we need. That's 91, includes the safekeeping. Is that not right?
At that specific day, yes, sir.
So it's not 91 plus 4, it's 91.
It's probably 91 plus 4 today.
No. We're talking when the date this report was done.
Oh, it was just 91. The whole total was 91.
Okay,
mm-hmm.
That was all. All right.
Can I ask one last question?
Well.
If he won't allow it.
Go ahead. I thought you were elevating it.
Yeah, each month we get this report. We got male, female, and you list the number for each day of the male, female in this report. Would it be possible also to this report to list what your capacity is for the male and the capacity for the female?
What report are you looking at? You're looking at my report that goes to the state?
Section 4. It's called a local confinement report.
No, those papers come down just like they are. We just have to fill in what's available on the sheet. That's a state report.
Okay.
That's a document that the state has issued to us to fill out and send to them every month.
Mm-hmm. How many male prisoners can you house And how many female prisoners can you house?
You can only house 13 female prisoners. And the bedding space that's left out of the 85 is male population, supposedly.
They're only supposed to house 85.
Total of 85.
But we have 90.
What do you do with your overflow, ma'am?
I overflow them.
Well, I mean you got 85. I know you overflow them. What do you do with them? You don't have an 85 bed. You got 95 people.
You didn't hear what she said.
They overflow them.
They sleep
where? On the floor. That's with mats. And I overflow them.
That's exactly what I wanted.
Sleep on the floor. See, even with the 85 bed capacity, you have to understand that when we get ready to separate them, 18, 19, 20 of those beds are misdemeanors. So it doesn't matter if you only got 13 misdemeanors and you got 20 bed spaces and somebody comes in that's a felon. You cannot house them in the misdemeanor block.
How many people have you had at a time sleeping on the floor? I know it's not every day, but at the max, how many have you had on the floor, on that concrete? Didn't you have a mattress?
Didn't have a mattress, probably 10.
And them that was on the floor that had a mattress, how many was on the floor?
Throughout the jail, probably 21.
Thank you.
Where are these prisoners being housed?
The ones that are housed out? I have one that's in Craven Correction, and then my other three are in Central Prison.
Mm-hmm. And what do you know what it cost us a day to do that?
It depends. If they have to seek medical treatment, surgery, or something like that, we'll charge for that. Your basic charge is like $85 a day, but they charge us for every pill that they give them. Every time they have a psych visit, they charge us for that. They charge us for everything up there in safekeeping.
It could be $110 a day, just as easily.
It could be $225 a day, just as easily. Yeah.
But I thought the Central Prison, they only took after conviction.
Not for safekeeping. They have a hospital there.
I got you.
Not for safekeeping.
Okay. I got you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Moving on to the